Funziona.
E quando siamo pronti, siamo tutti già messi?
Sì.
Quindi possiamo cominciare?
Sì.
Ok, cominciamo? Benissimo. Okay, so good morning, everyone. My name is Sandro Scandolo. I'm the scientific coordinator of here at the ICTP, the International Center for Theoretical Physics. And I'd like to welcome all of you to this workshop today on science, sustainable food, how scientific instruments can help food and biodiversity issues for the planet and its inhabitants' health. It's really a pleasure to welcome all of you. By the way, I'd like to welcome not only the ones that are in person here at the ICTP in Trieste, but also the ones that are connecting online. I guess we have about 30 participants currently connected, and there may be more connecting later on. Regards from the director of ICTP, Professor Attista Bolcar, who is unfortunately unable to be here today. He's traveling at the moment. Now, as you probably know, ICTP is one of the many members of the constellation of UN agencies, and we are actually part of the UNESCO family. And so we're particularly sensitive to issues like sustainable development. Of course, we focus on science, basic science, especially physics and mathematics, but we have strong activities also in research areas that have a direct impact on sustainability, like climate modeling, study of materials for renewable energies, human ecology. We've been organizing a workshop last year. Some of you might remember that. So the theme of this workshop is really extremely important for us, and I'd really like to I'm glad to see you, many colleagues and many people, and also many institutions. As you certainly know, we're all, especially we as a UN agency, particularly, we pay particular attention to the sustainable development goals. And among all of them, there is certainly one on food, but there's also one which I would like to highlight, the last one, in fact, the 17th sustainable development goal, which is partnership to achieve the goals. And I think this is really a beautiful example of a partnership trying to address these challenges together. And I'd like to take this opportunity also to thank the Fondazione, of which I'm also part, but especially Stefano Fantoni, who is here with us, the president of Fondazione Internazionale Trieste, for having led this initiative called Trieste Laboratory for Quantitative Sustainability. And I would like to emphasize the word quantitative sustainability. As a scientist, a member of the ICTP, this is really something that we pay special attention, the fact that we have to address these issues starting from a quantitative approach. I would also like to thank the OGS, the Geophysical Observatory, for co-leading this laboratory, and all those who have been involved in the organization of this workshop, in particular Michele Morgante, who is here, the workshop director, who will take the floor later on. We have today also our authorities, the local authorities. We have the local minister for research, university, and many other things, but I'm thankful for her present. The mayor will join us soon. We're just waiting for him. And so with this, again, welcome everybody. The session is now open, and I would like to now give the floor to Professor Nicola CASAGLI from the Geophysical Observatory, please.
Okay, thank you very much for the introduction. Dear authorities, researchers, and participants, it's with great pleasure that I welcome you to this workshop of the Trieste Laboratory on Quantitative Sustainability. This laboratory is a new initiative proposed by the OGS, that is the National Institute of Oceanography and Applied Geophysics, together with the Fondazione FIT of Stefano Fantoni, and in partnership with all the research center and university of the Friuli Venezia Giulia region. This workshop today is focused on how scientific instruments can help food and biodiversity for the planet and its inhabitant health. And it, this is an important topic in the domain of sustainability. We are honored to have you with us today, and we gather to share insight, knowledge, experience on one most pressing issue of our time, sustainability, and today in particular, the sustainability of food. We know that the world is facing a variety of environmental, social, and economic challenges that require urgent and concerted action. Climate change, pollution, biodiversity loss, and social inequality are just a few examples of these issues that threaten our planet and our well-being. Therefore, it's important that we work together to find solutions that can help us build a more sustainable future for ourselves and, above all, for future generations. The Trieste Laboratory on Quantitative Sustainability is committed to advancing research and innovation in the field of sustainability, also finding new tools for proposing quantitative measures of sustainability. And in order to give a quantitative assessment of the sustainable development goals of the United Nations. Throughout this workshop, today and tomorrow, we'll explore how scientific instruments can help us address issues such as soil degradation, climate change, food waste, and the loss of biodiversity. We will also hear about innovative technologies and approaches that are already making a difference in the field of sustainable food. So, once again, thank you for your valuable contribution to the Trieste Laboratory on Quantitative Sustainability. I hope that you find this workshop informative, inspiring, and productive. Let us work together to build a more sustainable world. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Nicola. And now the floor is with Stefano Fantoni, the president of the Fondazione Internazionale Trieste.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you to all of you for being here. Really, thank you very much. I'm really very happy to see you in this hall and also in remote. This is the second workshop or event that this laboratory, this very young laboratory, is in early stage now, has been organizing. There are others in program that the scientific council of the laboratories is building up, and so I am really waiting very much from this workshop. What I'm asking to all of you is not only I will listen to you, obviously, but I will try to understand what kind of assignments you give us as a laboratory. So I are looking for problems that we want to solve or that need to be solved. And we want to know from you what is going on and what we should do. As a laboratory, as I say, we are very young, but we are still doing something. I have in front of me a book, what is called conceptual book, and that is ready, is done by the members of this laboratory in a complete way, and is being published now, and Springer is going to publish that in open access. So that is the title of the book is Quantitative Sustainability. And the subtitle is Interdisciplinary Research for Sustainable Development Goals. So the title of this book is telling you actually what we want to try to do. Actually, I'm not sure that we will be able to do it, but we will try very strongly. We will try to approach the problems of sustainability in a quantitative way, as Nicola CASAGLI have been saying just a second ago. And that is why we are setting in a place which is sort of church of fundamentality. I've been asked by some people that have been known about this this meeting, but why theoretical physics are so interested in food, what they're doing there. It's not easy to answer to this question, but nevertheless, I mean, if my answer would be, which is still a dream, is not really something which is extremely well defined, is that we would like, all of us would like to understand whether sustainability is only a, some set of things, of sustainable issues that are being just emerging in our world, or there is some also some fundamental structure of it. That's why physicists might be important in this issue. So when we, when I was saying, I'm really, I'm very keen to listen you very much, because I really would like to go deeper and deeper. I mean, not me only, but all of us deeper into these issues. And so, I must say that this actually is the main issue that you are trying to do. The second main issue is coming from the word interdisciplinary research. Which is everything and nothing at the same time, you know, because actually the devil of interdisciplinarity is just to study and to look at and to know at a very low deep level, say to know nothing of everything. I mean, so we have to avoid this devil, and so we know and we have been learning that the true interdisciplinarity can grow only on at the basis of strong disciplinary knowledge. And that is not easy to do. And that's why is needed a laboratory like this. Otherwise, everything can be done in many institutions that are around. I mean, everybody can do that. But you need coordination. You need something that really is capable of growing up for disciplinarity, this attitude to listen and to talk with other people and to understand in a very holistic way, let me say. Maybe even the word holistic is a little bit, virtual in a way, but what we should do. So with this spirit, I really thank you very much again. And I'm very keen to listen to all of you in these 2 days, which I am sure will be very proficuous. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stefano. And now we have Professor Valter Sergo, Deputy Rector of the University of Trieste. Valter, please.
Thank you, everybody. I will start from a piece of information that I got 2 weeks ago at the opening of the academic year at the university. There was a lecture about green surgery, the impact of surgery on sustainability. And the piece of information that struck me is that a simple breast surgery, an operation lasting maybe 2 hours, has the same carbon footprint of a car crossing Europe from Madrid to Kiev. It's enormous. And right now, the medical world is starting to address these issues. The one that will be addressed here today are even more important, because everybody needs food. And the complete supply chain of food can really benefit from what science can say. The agriculture, transformation, distribution, use and waste. Everybody needs food. We all need food to survive. And each and single, every single step can be addressed by what you will say today. I will finish with a final comment stemming from a book which probably most of you have read, The Omnivore's Dilemma by Mike Pollan. The book, which is not a scientific textbook, but it's very clear in emphasizing the enormous damage that we have done to agricultural biodiversities in the last century. Families that were self-sufficient in the States in terms of food have gone to the level of raising only one product. So we are losing biodiversity in the food chain, and through scientific instrument, I think we need now to reverse that course, which I deem is one of the most important parts this type of congresses can try to address and provide end users with the cultural and scientific instrument to address. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Walter. And now we have the Dr. Alessia Rosolen, the Regional Minister for Research University. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You will speak in Italian.
Speak in Italian.
There will be a translation.
It's better for you.
Yes.
Allora, buongiorno a tutti. Mi permetto di parlare in italiano perché sono convinta che voi siete molto più bravi di me e quindi lo comprendete bene. Io devo iniziare ovviamente come di prassi, però in realtà è un ringraziamento di sostanza alla lungimiranza e forse all'ambizione che la FIT e l'OGS hanno avuto nel individuare in questo progetto uno dei temi ampi del dibattito su che cos'è l'innovazione e cos'è la sostenibilità. La cosa, a mio avviso, straordinaria di questo progetto e importante di questo progetto è che si parte da un assioma: la tecnologia non è un settore ma un'abilitazione, e questo è il primo dei temi che qui dentro viene affrontato. E proprio perché la tecnologia è qualche cosa che viene fatta dall'uomo, è dovere dell'uomo governarla con intelligenza. Credo che il problema più grande di tutti gli anni dello sviluppo umano sia stato quello di vivere sull'hic et nunc, di immaginare con quali modalità fare i passi avanti che erano necessari al sistema scientifico. Siamo arrivati in un momento di dibattito a livello globale, non solo ovviamente nazionale, europeo o locale, nel quale invece il ragionamento va fatto in maniera ampia, in maniera trasversale, in maniera di unire quelle che sono, come dico sempre, le scienze dure con quella che è la scienza umanistica, e di comprendere che qualsiasi settore della ricerca, oltre al tema del trasferimento tecnologico, che è un dato ormai assodato e legato a tutto il sistema della ricerca, è legato in maniera particolare al tema dello sviluppo umano e a tutto un tema, permettetemi di intervenire su questo, di legislazioni e di valutazioni economiche che parlano in realtà di quella che è la sostenibilità sociale, non di oggi e non solo di oggi, ma di un futuro che ovviamente andiamo a disegnare. Credo che questa sia... Ah, sorry.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. I'm sorry for speaking in Italian, so there'll be a translation in English. I would like to start by thanking the farsightedness and ambition of FIT and OGS for engaging in this project, for investing in a debate on innovation and sustainability. The importance, the extraordinary character of this project is that it entails that technology is not just a sector, it is an enabler. This is an important issue that is going to be debated here. Technology is made by men, and men need to use it with intelligence. This human development has been lived up to now in the hic et nunc fashion, but today at regional, national, and European, but above all at global level, we need to carry on a debate which must be wider in order to unite science and humanities and understand that every sector of research, and not just technology transfer, which affects every sector, of course, is regards the human development, but also the laws and the economic assessment of our sustainable society of today and of the future.
Bene, grazie. Davo per scontato che tutti capissero quello che stavo dicendo, scusatemi davvero. E, dicevo, rispetto a questo tema di proiezione e di visione futura, credo che sia compito dell'amministrazione regionale non solo e non tanto rafforzare, come credo abbia fatto nel corso degli anni, quello che è il sistema della ricerca scientifica, ma entrare e lavorare in maniera compatta su una rete trasversale e multidisciplinare che ci consenta in qualche modo di uscire dalla dicotomia ricerca-applicazione nella quale abbiamo vissuto, credo, tutto il Novecento e forse in parte anche su tutta la parte dell'inizio di questo nuovo secolo. Io ringrazio e ovviamente do la disponibilità dell'amministrazione regionale ad approfondire tutti questi temi, perché sono temi, credo, di visione e di responsabilità, non solo di sostenibilità, rispetto ai quali la politica ha la necessità di essere condotta per mano rispetto a tutta una serie di scelte, e questo è un dato importante, ma soprattutto rispetto a un senso del limite che bisogna imporre in maniera determinante a qualsiasi parte del nostro progresso e a tutti i nostri percorsi di sostenibilità. Vi auguro buon lavoro, domani non sarò con voi a Udine, ma sono convinta che tutti i soggetti, e di questo sarò felicissima di avere i risultati, che tutti i soggetti che interverranno ci spiegheranno con quali modalità il nostro paese e la nostra regione possono intervenire su temi importanti come l'agri-food, dell'agri-tech e il food tech, ma ci possano anche indicare una strada rispetto a quelle che sono le azioni che la politica può, ma soprattutto deve mettere in campo. Grazie e buona giornata.
As again, in regards to this issue of future vision, the regional administration has a role of strengthening the local system of scientific research, but also need to work in order to promote a multidisciplinary network that overcome the now obsolete dichotomy of research on one end and applied science on the other, which has characterized the 20th century and our century. I believe I would like to thank you, and the Friuli Venezia Giulia region remains at your disposal in order to deepen this debate on every issue you may think is important in order to promote this vision on sustainability. Policy needs guidance to make the right choices and also to remind everyone that the sense of limits in human progress is pivotal, and especially in sustainable development. I would like to wish you a fruitful course in these few days. Tomorrow I won't be able to be in Udine, but I'm sure that all stakeholders will be able to explain how our region can actually work in order to promote agri-technology and food technology, and also how can we take effective political actions. Thank you.
Grazie mille veramente, Assessore. Thank you very much. And we're now supposed to have the mayor, but I guess it's late. So what I would suggest is that we continue with the program, and now we're going to have an introduction to the workshop, which will be given by Professor Claudio Tiribelli, Scientific Director of the Italian Liver Foundation here, and Professor Michele Morgante, who is the from the University of Udine, but is also the workshop scientific coordinator. So I will kindly ask you to